大家好，我们还是在学第十三课第二个对话的语法。那今天我们要学的语法是 reduplication of verbs。好，想一下上个学期 when we were on the food chapter， 我们学过 reduplication of adjectives。好，想一下 how did we describe 酸辣汤？是不是酸辣汤，酸酸的？辣辣的，非常好喝。好 ，How do we describe？ 凉茶，凉茶，冰冰的，凉凉的，对不对？还有王鹏，高高的，帅帅的。好, with reduplication of adjectives, we actually use this structure. Again, we only use it with monosyllable adjectives to give a positive connotation. All right? Now, with verbs, we can also reduplicate verbs. And when we reduplicate the verb, we usually are asking someone to help us. All right, so with reduplication of verbs, we're making ourselves sound more polite. The tone of the sentence is more soft. OK, 我们看一下例子。我用用你的电脑可以吗？我用用你的电脑可以吗？ Now, of course, you can take out one of the 用 and you say, 我用你的电脑可以吗？ That would still be grammatically correct, but doesn't sound very nice. All right, you're basically saying, I use a computer. Is that okay? Whereas, 我用用你的电脑, may I use your computer? All right, to make yourself sound more polite. 你考完试,我们一起去公园走走,聊聊天儿, as a suggestion. Right, 我们一起去公园走走,聊聊天儿。Of course, you can add, but to the end.他想看看我的新手机。他想看看我的新手机。Now, in this sentence, we have two verbs, 想和看。You cannot reduplicate 想, right? Because this is the action verb. 看 is the action verb. She wants to take a look at my new cell phone. 她想看看我的新手机。All right, now let's think about how would you make your request more polite. Okay, how would you say, can you please help me? Now, without this structure, would you say, 你可以帮我吗? That actually is not very polite. Okay, now, you want to say, 你可以帮帮我吗? 你可以帮帮我吗? Okay, can you please show me your test paper? 你可以给我看你的考试吗? Again, still it's not very polite. You want to say, 你可以给我看看你的考试吗? Okay, may I taste this 糖醋鱼? 我可以尝尝糖醋鱼吗？尝 means to taste. Okay, 我可以尝尝糖醋鱼吗？好，看一下这个语法，虽然容易，但是同学们常常不用。Okay, now from now on, if you want to ask for a favor, you want to request to do something, you want to make sure yourself sound very polite and appropriate. So please use this structure from now on. 老师，你可以帮帮我吗？老师，你可以看看我的作业吗？好，如果你有问题的话，请明天上课问老师。谢谢同学们。